Hi, I have just started editing this video and these will be necessary. Maybe make it a drinking game, I don't know. Hello, welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you are new here. I'm Noelle, the 7 is my Enneagram type, and this is my October TBR, which is going to look extremely ambitious. And I think rather than trying to read every single one of these in the month of October, this is more like my October hopefuls, or the books that I will be reaching for in October, because I have FOMO. I want the fall vibes. I want to have a autumnal reading month, but I'm not crazy about thrillers, or certainly not horror, and I definitely don't want to have a month of like thrillers and horror, because that's just really not my thing. So I decided, I went through my whole like TBR cart and pulled out all of the books that gave me vague autumn, fall vibes of some kind, and I just went with it. So I have this gigantic stack that I will show you, all of my fall vibey books that I will attempt. Because also the truth is, I'm not really a fall person. I wish that I was. I'm so happy for everyone that is excited for fall. I'm just not crazy about Halloween. I'm not crazy about pumpkins. It's just really not my favorite time of year. My favorite time of year is summer, and then spring, and then winter, and then fall. So like in that order. But it's fine. I really want to be wooed by fall, and so I'm going to jump headfirst into the vibes in October, and this is what I'm working with. So there are like 10,000 great readathons going on in the month of October, but I, as of now filming this, am not committing to any of them. I told myself a while ago that I wanted to give myself October off to chill and kind of catch up and try to like avoid burning out or things like that. So I'm not really jumping into any readathons, especially because a lot of them, like I mentioned, are just not necessarily my speed, which is fine. I'm just, this is my month of taking a break from readathons, kind of, with one small exception that I don't think will be announced yet by the time this goes out. But there is a tiny asterisk to that rule that will be explained very soon. So the first one to get out of the way, because it's also the only one that I don't own right now, is Cunning Women by Elizabeth Lee, which I just talked about in my Hot Girl Book Club announcement video, if you haven't seen that. And October is the first month of Hot Girl Book Club, and the pick for October is Cunning Women, which is about this kind of family in 1600s, and they are vaguely witchy, but in that time they're called cunning women because they don't want to be called witches. So it's kind of just like an open secret, like a colloquial term of cunning women you can go to for like salves and hexes and woo-woo solutions to whatever problems you are facing. And like during the day, they are very much like pariahs and shunned by the people of the town, but by night, a lot of those people from the town will quietly seek them out to be cured or have their problems solved, etc. And also another subplot is that one of the women meets this golden boy, wealthy man in the town, and they form a connection, and it does not sound like it goes very well, according to the synopsis, that people are saying, oh, she must have bewitched him to be interested in her, and all of that. That is the synopsis, so we will be talking about that for book club. But besides that, I have really no plans, so I just have all of these vibey books that I will stop teasing and actually show you. The first one on my stack is The Immortalist by Chloe Benjamin, and I have heard very mixed reviews about this on BookTube, but I just think, first of all, look at the cover and tell me this is not a fall read, but second of all, I think that this has all of the ingredients of books that I will like. Like, all of those, like, quirky things in stories that just, like, really gets me going. I think this is gonna be like a hidden gem for me. Let me explain. This starts off the book flap by saying, if you knew the date of your death, how would you live your life? And then explains how in 1969, these four siblings seek out this traveling psychic who claims to be able to tell anyone the day that they'll die. And then the rest of the book like follows the lives of those four siblings and what they do and how everything goes. And so at the bottom, it says, this is both a dazzling family love story and a sweeping novel of remarkable ambition and depth. The Immortalist probes the line between destiny and choice, reality and illusion, this world and the next. It is a deeply moving testament to the power of story, the nature of belief, and the unrelenting pull of familial bonds. Like that says for Noelle specifically. That sounds like everything that I try to seek out in like funky books like this. This is one that I definitely hope to read in October, especially because it does seem to have the vibes. I love all of that stuff, the like life and death, destiny, all of that kind of thing. Love it, can't wait. Next is Susanna Clarke's Piranesi, which is like actually so tiny compared to like The Immortalist, is literally a tiny book. And it was just recently announced that this won this year's Women's Prize for Fiction, which was up against like very steep competition. And so as soon as that was announced, I already had this book on my cart and was like, oh my God, I have to read this. And it does have the vibes. It has this like dark kind of October-y cover. And then the end pages are like seashells, which I love so much. And I keep reading the flap to try and figure out how to summarize and explain this for you. And it seems just so mysterious, so atmospheric. It's told in this kind of magical mythology inspired alternative reality where Piranesi lives in this mysterious house where strange things happen and kind of lives there alone. It's blurbed by Madeline Miller, who calls it an adventure through a brilliant new fantasy world and a deep meditation on the human condition, feeling lost and being found. And Aaron Morgenstern has also blurbed it and says, this is the sort of book that I love wordlessly handing to someone so they can have the pleasure of uncovering the secrets for themselves. This book is a treasure. So I don't think I really want to understand the premise any more than that. And I feel like it's gonna be quick. Like this could be maybe a one sitting kind of a read. Hopefully happening in October. The next one is A Universe of Wishes, which is a short story anthology edited by Danielle Clayton. And this is another installment in the We Need Diverse Books anthology series, which I haven't read any of the others. I think it's like short story anthology collections, kind of a series. And this one I picked as far as vibes go because of the cover. It just feels very October-y on the cover. But this is kind of like fantasy. I think it's YA. I think the short stories are YA fantastical stories. This says, this powerful and inclusive collection contains a universe of wishes for a braver and more beautiful world. 15 award-winning and celebrated diverse authors deliver stories about a princess without need of a prince, a monster long misunderstood, memories that vanish with a single spell, and voices that refuse to stay silent in the face of injustice. That is kind of self-explanatory, and I just need a good short story collection in my life. I think this came out last December, and I had it pre-ordered, and it for some reason it has just sat on my cart all year. And I think October is the time to finally crack it open. Next is The Girl and the Goddess by Nikita Gill, Stories and Poems of Divine Wisdom. And I have been meaning to read Nikita Gill forever. And I picked this up, I think, from like Target recently because the cover just really sucked me in. Again, a very October-y cover. And I believe that this is a collection of poems that also tell one like thread of a story underneath, which is just the most intriguing and exciting premise for me. I have read the premise before and I don't really want to know anything more, so I'm not gonna actually read that part. But the little blurb says, let her be a little less human, a little more divine, give her heart armor so it doesn't break as easily as mine. I'm just so interested in the concept of poems that stand alone on their own as individual poems, but also add up to like a greater sum of their parts into a whole actual story. I can't wait. There's also no good reason that I haven't read this one yet either, and I think this will be the perfect time. I'm kind of losing my light, so we're just gonna make the rest of this video happen really quick, which is great, because I can get a little long-winded, we all know this. Next is Midnight at the Blackbird Cafe by Heather Weber. I just picked this up recently from my local used bookstore because it sounds so fun and uplifting. I think it's a romance, but also very mysterious and like has magical realism elements to it. This woman returns to either her hometown or her grandmother's hometown because of like a family kind of a thing, and she keeps being drawn to this mysterious Blackbird Cafe where they have some kind of like this mysterious pie, and there's an urban legend where if you eat a slice of the pie, you will find the answers that you've been seeking for, which is just very vague and intriguing, and I love that. I think this will probably be kind of a slower paced character exploration, and all of the reviews say it's very like lighthearted and uplifting, which is something that maybe I could use in between some of these like deeper, heavier books that I'm attempting during the month. So I think this also just fits the vibe anyways, as far as like mystery and intrigue kind of go. I mean, Midnight at the Blackbird Cafe is just a very October-y title, I think. Next, I have Literary Witches, A Celebration of Magical Women Writers. And I bought this for myself for my last year's birthday. Like, I literally haul this in a birthday book haul from last year, and I also bought, there's like an oracle card deck that goes along with this, like sold separately but kind of bouncing off of each other, and I use that deck all the time and I love it, but I haven't actually read the book, and it talks about a lot of like iconic classic women writers but with this kind of like witchy overlay on them as if they were witches themselves, and it's so much fun. I don't know. Obviously, for very clear reasons, this fits the theme of October for sure, and also just kind of a classical way to learn more about some of my heroes in this fun, like, funky witchy way, you know? Okay, actually there's only three more, so we can make this lighting work. I have The Entangled Life, How Fungi Make Our Worlds, Change Our Minds, and Shape Our Futures by Merlin Sheldrake. And this was sent to me by Page One Books, which is like the only book subscription box that I have, and I swear by them, I love them so much. And they sent me this, I think, early in the summer, and I remember thinking, okay, this is gonna be perfect for fall, because come on, reading about mushrooms is the most fall, like, vibe I can possibly imagine. Even the cover with all of these like cool different fungi and mushrooms, I can't wait. I just want to stare at it. I'm excited to learn about this entire world of fungi, and because it's something I know nothing about, but I'm sure is very interesting and has all kinds of little hidden nuggets and gems and fascinating aspects to it. So I don't know if anyone else is interested in like quirky niche nonfiction like this, but it's been a while since I've read like a nature nonfiction book that really just like lit me up like this. I'm so excited about this, which is weird that I'm this excited about a fungus book, you know, but that's that kind of just is the theme of the day. I think this will be perfect is what I'm getting at. The next one I have is The Slaughterman's Daughter by Yaniv Ikovits. And this, I guess, is a recent release. This came out in February of this year. I had no idea until, again, my local used bookstore posted this, and I was like, oh my god, please hold that for me. I'll come in this weekend. And it's actually very large. I looked up the synopsis, like, before I bought it, and everyone says that it's, the like, this really fun, hilarious satire that also kind of probes into Russian history and family drama. And I'm like, give that to me. Give me a funny Russian historical fiction feminist family drama. Like, yes, please, obviously. This is a tale of two Jewish sisters in late 19th century Russia, filled with, quote, boundless imagination and a vibrant style. One of the sisters grew up being fascinated by her father's profession of ritual slaughter and wants to learn how to do that herself, and then learns the trade and kind of gives it up to become the wife of a cheesemaker, but always keeps the knife strapped to her leg. And there's a bunch of like other things that happen in this synopsis that have to do with the Russian secret police, the Russian Empire, and family, and kind of a quest with all of that stuff combined, and it's supposed to be extremely hilarious is what all of the reviews say. And I don't really know how those things can all add up so perfectly. And so I'm excited to take a bite out of this, even though this might be the longest one on the list. And for some reason, maybe because it's a satire, I'm not intimidated by that. Where usually bigger books I'm like more hesitant towards. But for some reason, everyone says this is just full of jokes. So like, sign me up. I want to find out what that is. Last on my list of October hopefuls in this little TBR is Winter by Marissa Meyer, because this is the last book in the series, I guess not counting Stars Above, which I think is like a story collection at the end, but Winter is like the conclusion of the series, and I have been following along with the Lunar Chronicles readathon the last couple of months, and we are wrapping up with Winter in October. And maybe it should be called Autumn, I don't know. But Winter is one of the characters, and I've been really, really enjoying being back in this world, and I am excited but also kind of sad to get to the end of the series again, because it's been such a fun reread for me, especially like kind of reading everyone else's live reactions in the Discord has just been such a fun little piece of my reading year. If you don't know, the Lunar Chronicles is a YA sci-fi series that also weaves in different fairy tale retellings. So Winter is a Snow White retelling, and the first one, Cinder, is a Cinderella retelling. There's also Little Red Riding Hood and Rapunzel are like the four main books, the four main characters in the series. And it's a great time, and I can't wait to finish it. We did it. Now I have to hold all of these up and be honest with myself about how many books this actually is. Oh my. This is a little bit excessive, but that's okay. We're gonna roll with it. Oh no, I'm gonna lose my mushrooms off the top. Okay. So this is the list of attempted reads or hopeful reads. The pile that I will reach from, select from, for my October vibey mood reading. Maybe that's what I'll go with. So ideally, for my October wrap-up, it should be any selection from this pile, and also Cunning Women, and also whatever audiobooks come in from the library. But we will cross that bridge when we get to it. Thank you so much for watching. Please let me know if you have read any of these, or if you have other like October feeling, like fall vibe reads that aren't thrillers or horror books, because I would love to know. I'm just not in the mood for thrillers and horror right now, but I just want to still like appreciate the time of year and kind of sit in that atmosphere. You know what I mean? Let me know. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very soon. Love you, bye.